firefighter has tested positive to coronavirus, forcing three stations to close. He's the third infected person to be at a Northern Beaches pub. Health officials are now scrambling to find the missing link between them.
This latest case comes as testing numbers nearly halved. There's also growing confusion over outside restrictions.
On the Northern Beaches, deja vu. Residents waking up to restrictions once again.
There's a lot of people, but everyone's out here exercising.
Pre-Christmas stay-at-home orders are in place, but on the southern end, there's an exception. Groups of 10 can gather outdoors.
I had a group just in front of us and they did a count. They said, eight, no, we're okay.
In Manly, locals were taking full advantage of that freedom.
I feel like there's a bit too many people out today, to be honest.
Up the road in DY, confusion.
Groups of two, only, exercise only. Sorry guys, you're not meant to sit down or sunbathe.
Police moving in to move people out.
We don't want to be in the news like Bronte last night.
The Premier clarifying the rules.
So if you're taking children to a playground or having a small barbecue, but you still have to maintain your social distancing.
On the northern side, it's only groups of five. Locals in the epicentre following the direction.
I've just been in isolation for 14 days, so it's good to be out.
As long as everyone follows the rules and we should be okay.
There were seven new cases overnight, six are linked to the Avalon cluster, one is under investigation. The outbreak on the Northern Beaches now sits at 122. Today's mystery case is a Northern Beaches firefighter, forcing the closure of Crow's Nest, DY and Beecroft stations. Dozens of firefighters are now in isolation. Replacement crews have been sent in to cover the gap.
The firefighter's infection has now opened a new line of inquiry into the initial source of the Northern Beaches outbreak. It's believed he picked up the virus here at the Belrose Hotel. He's now the third positive case associated with the venue.
The first, a man in his 20s who works at the hotel and was infected around December 10. He's one of the first known cases in the cluster. The firefighter visited the hotel the next day and a third positive case visited the bottle shop next door on December 17. There's now a call out for anyone who was there this month who is showing or has previously showed symptoms to get a test.
This is part of our detective work, to look at that upstream and see if we can establish any links.
The request came with an admission. Authorities may never find patient zero. The message for the rest of Greater Sydney:
reduce your mobility and your activity.
But space was limited at Bondi. Those who didn't want to soak up the sun hit suburban shopping centres for round two of sales. Crowds lined up to get into shops at Birkenhead, a steady stream of customers at the DFO. Further inland, a bustling Westfield Parramatta. Late today, confirmation a positive case had been at Casula Mall. The Northern Beaches cluster sparked one of the most impressive turnouts at testing sites in the country. As the outbreak began, there were just 7,500 tests. But as the seriousness of the cluster hit home, it gained momentum. By Monday, a new record was set with more than 44,000 tests. Thursday, it was smashed again, just shy of 70,000. Still, almost 40,000 on Christmas Day. In the last 24 hours, it dropped to 24,000. That's well over 300,000 tests in just 10 days.
We are at a critical stage in our response, and unless we have those high testing rates, it does not give us adequate assurance that we are not missing undetected lines of transmission.
Live to Miley Hogan. Miley, incredible testing numbers in the past few days. Is today's drop cause for concern?
And good evening. Authorities do want to see those numbers start to tick back up. They have said high testing rates will be crucial when they make their decisions about further easing the restrictions. We did hit a milestone in New South Wales today, though. 4 million tests have been done since January. Now, following the confusion on the beaches earlier today about outdoor gatherings, the council has revised its measures. The red and yellow flags are back up. Beaches are patrolled. Rock pools and playgrounds are open. And tonight, there are still big crowds down here, but people are following those physical distancing rules, and they will be patrolled and enforced. The changes came with a reminder: people living outside the Northern Beaches cannot enter this area to come to the beach. And the public health alert has been updated this evening. New venues in Casula and North Sydney. For the full list, head to the New South Wales website.
Okay, Miley Hogan, thank you.